Hey everybody, welcome back to another video here on the Washington Football Maniacs YouTube channel. My name is Greg Sykes. Welcome everybody. If you're new here, thank you for joining us. This channel is based on the Washington Commanders. This is a fan channel, and if you're a fan, then please, by all means, subscribe to this channel, because I try to put out videos on a daily basis or semi-daily basis whenever I possibly can. It depends on my schedule. With that said, let's just get into this video. So, you know, there's been some talk about Jahan Dotson and how he's been relatively quiet since he's come back from his injury. Now, when he came back from his injury, Taylor Heinicke was in at quarterback. He got maybe like one or two passes, I think, in his first game. And you kind of felt like, okay, Ron Rivera is bringing him back a little bit slowly. He'll get gradually more passes thrown his way. And then I believe in the next game, he had maybe one pass thrown his way again, and you didn't really see much of him. And this has continued to be a pattern up until this past game. He didn't have any passes thrown his way. As a matter of fact, I wasn't even sure if he was even on the field. But as well, we didn't see any passes thrown to Curtis Samuel either. So is this something that is up with Jahan Dotson, or is it more that has to do with Taylor Heinicke, your quarterback? And I would have to believe that it has a little bit more to do with your quarterback than it has to do with Jahan Dotson. Now, by all means, this is not a knock on Taylor Heinicke at all. This is just the matter of fact that you have to deal with quarterbacks who are comfortable and got a chemistry with certain wide receivers. They're going to look for those wide receivers before they look for others, right? So Terry McLaurin has been there longer than Jahan Dotson. And Taylor Heinicke has played with McLaurin more than Dotson. Now, it is true that McLaurin was not in training camp or anything like that. But for Heinicke, it doesn't matter, because, you know, he played pretty much the entire season last year. And then, of course, you know, he played a couple of games or so in the 2020 season, that playoff game as well. So he's had a lot of experience playing with Terry McLaurin. Hadn't really developed that much chemistry probably with Jahan Dotson. I believe Dotson played more with the first team in the preseason than he did with the second team and the third team. So there's probably more chemistry that you're going to see with Taylor Heinicke and McLaurin than you are with Dotson. I think that's part of it as well. I think the other part of it is where Dotson did go out with an injury, that he lost a little bit of momentum, right? I mean, once you kind of go out and you lose that momentum, you're out for about, I think he was out for what, four games? At least three or four games. Then you almost have to start all over again. And I think that's what kind of happened with Jahan Dotson. And because of that, I think that you have to rebuild. You have to almost start back to the square one. And I think the whole message of this is just basically, you got to be patient. Us as Washington fans, I've noticed that we tend to give up on players way too quickly. You know, we label them as busts like halfway through their rookie season. And hey, I've probably been guilty of that myself. But we should not start labeling Jahan Dotson a bust at all. I think he's shown quite a bit, you know, especially before he got hurt, that he can be a playmaker for us. And I think that, you know, we've seen a little bit from Dyami Brown as well. I think, you know, he hasn't, you know, exploded and been this big play wide receiver for us, but he's made some plays. It's just that Taylor Heinicke right now, he's not spreading the ball as much as what Carson Wentz did. Carson was better with spreading the ball around than what Heinicke has been, but I think Heinicke, he's got that mentality of this is my last game ever in the NFL, so I need to look for my playmakers. I'm trying to make the play. And that's just kind of how his style is. And so he's going to look for Terry McLaurin first. If the other guys are open, he's going to go to those guys. That's just kind of how it's going to be until he gets comfortable with Jahan Dotson, a little bit more comfortable with Diami Brown, those guys like that. I think that he's probably pretty comfortable with Logan Thomas. So, not to say, folks, you need to just chill out, but folks, you need to chill out. Jahan Dotson's going to be just fine. I really think in year two, you're going to see Jahan Dotson really start to probably challenge Taylor Heinicke. I keep getting Taylor and Terry mixed up. I think you're really going to challenge. You're going to see that Jahan Dotson is going to challenge Terry McLaurin for the number one spot because I think both of those guys are extremely talented. And having those two guys and then a third with hopefully Brown being that third guy or Curtis Samuel, of course. I mean, we've got such a load at wide receiver. I mean, honestly, you do start to wonder why is this team not scoring more than, 20 points a ball game? But that's a video for another time. Anyway, let me know in the comments section what you think. Is Jahan Dotson a bust? I don't think he is.
Hey, you stayed until the very end. Thank you so much. Watch another one right now.